It can take as little as 60 seconds for a car to fill up with water. Now imagine, you're inside the car, it's flipped, it's dark outside, and you have kids strapped in their car seats in the back.
We're not trying to make you panic. We're trying to help you prepare. The Lehigh Acres Fire Department says they respond to a car in a canal about once a month. So NBC2 anchor Nate Foy teamed up with those firefighters to show you how to get out alive.
Well, Kelly, you said it right there. The first thing that you need to know to get out alive is what to do. You need to be prepared. I want you to think about roads near you that where water could come into play, like this one, for example, in Lehigh Acres. It runs right over a canal. It's also very prevalent in Cape Coral. It's a very real possibility in Southwest Florida. We hope it never happens, but if it does, this is what you need to know to get out alive.
911, what is your emergency?
911, what is your emergency?
How many people are in the vehicle?
In a sinking car, every second counts.
Can we get our car?
Sometimes it's 30 seconds, but it could also be up to as a couple minutes.
And help.
I'm in the canal.
You gotta try to get the windows down as quickly as possible.
Is often far away.
Open the window and get out of that car.
Unless we are right around the corner on that same block, there is gonna be a delay, and that could be the difference between life and death.
This driver, who ended up in a canal in Lehigh Acres in December, managed to get to the top of his car, where firefighters could rescue him. But getting there in the stunning, frightening moments after a crash can be overwhelming.
You just got in a wreck.
Lehigh Acres Fire Captain Anthony Rocco tells me that's why you need to make a plan of escape now.
So the first thing would be self-rescue, get your bearings, and get the window down.
But if your window isn't working, you may need to break it.
So in a moment here, I'm going to throw on some gear and try to kick out a window in this car. Explain how difficult it is to actually break a window with your arm or your leg.
Very difficult. It's not like the movies.
Throwing on the full suit or? Okay. And what do you think? Do you think I'm going to be able to break it?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Can you break it?
Maybe.
All right, now we got a challenge.
Now all windows are created differently, so.
So I could get an easy window?
Yes.
I'm gonna need to take an Instagram in this. All right, now we're gonna see if I am capable of kicking out this window. All right, first one, not good enough. Second one, still not good enough.
Then, on my 16th try.
I was like, let's get this one more try. And then I
all right.
Took like five more. A lot of people aren't wearing these boots, so it's a lot more dangerous in other situations. All right, you just saw how hard it is to kick out a window. Now I'm gonna show you how much easier it is with a window punch. It costs just $5. You can get this, just leave it in your glove compartment. You pull it out, it looks like this, and you're gonna put it right up against the corner of the window. So remember, you want to go after the driver's or the passenger side windows. The front and back are too hard to break. And to demonstrate that, I'm going to hit it as hard as I can with a pro bar. Take a look at this.
People look at the front windshield or the rear window will be a safety glass that has a film on it. So even if you crack it, it's still staying together as one piece. And you're not going to be able to free yourself in that vehicle.
Hopefully people, when they see the story, will get the window puncher. If they don't, worst case scenario, what would you do in that situation?
Anything that you can concentrate that Man, force on that window.
That's not budging.
If you need to take your keys out, put it in your hand, would be better than just trying to turn and kick out the window.
I cannot stress the importance of buying a window punch like you saw in the story, or this one right here. It's a little bit different, but it has a seatbelt cutter. So if you can't get your seatbelt off, that's another thing to be aware of. A lot of people ask, what do I do if my kid is in the back seat? The priority still has to be to get that window down, because you can't help your kids if you don't have an open window. The final possibility here that hopefully doesn't happen, but if you can't get your window down, the water will start to rise in the car. And once the car is completely submerged with water, the pressure on the inside and outside will equalize, and you'll be able to just open your car door, swim up to the surface, and escape. That is how you will get out alive in this horrible situation. Reporting live in Lehigh Acres, Nate Foy, NBC2.